You may have heard of the term no code or low code and just kind of nodded along thinking, yeah, one day maybe I'll really understand what that is. Well, if you're not crystal clear on exactly what no code means, you've come to the right place because in this video, I'm breaking down what no code does and why it has the power to change and transform your life. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting. We are a no-code consulting firm that has implemented hundreds of different scenarios for our clients over the years. Now, before we get into the actual topic of this video, namely what is no code, I want to take a moment to invite you to join me for my automation training. Automation is one of those elements we're going to be talking about at length in today's video. And if you really want to leverage the power of no code, understanding how to build automated processes without using any code is going to be paramount to your adoption of the new generation of tech. So if that's of interest, if you want to get started and understand the fundamentals of automation, check out my free training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I'll include links below, but without further ado, let's hop into the actual heart of this video. And I want to preface this by saying that it's going to be a little different from my normal videos. Normally, we do a screen share. We are going to be in my screen looking at some stuff, actually breaking down a problem, building something in software. But this video is unique because it is mostly theory. We're just going to be talking about what these tools are, how you can implement them, and what the different things to anticipate are as you start adopting no code. So we have to start off by defining what no code is. No code, or sometimes called low code, is this new movement, this new idea out of software that allows anyone to build and maintain their own app so that they can automate processes and streamline business operations. In short, it means that you, as a non-coder, can come along, adopt a new software, and ultimately build it and customize it in such a way that is unique for your business and helps you streamline your operations. Whether that's getting more organized, whether it's automating processes, or somewhere in between. Now, ultimately, no code comes down to three main parts. Number one is where you're storing your information. So every time you go to build something in no code, there's going to be an element of data storage for you. Now, to fill this need, on this channel, we largely rely on a database tool called Airtable. Airtable is cloud-based, doesn't require any code to get started, although they do allow for just a small amount of code if you want to really ramp things up to the next level. But there are numerous different databases that you can choose from, and then even some solutions that store data that aren't databases per se. Think, for example, Microsoft Excel in the cloud, or even Google Sheets. There are some newer tools as well, things like Notion or Knack, that are emulating what Airtable does and makes available. So ultimately, almost all projects you build in no code need a place to store your information, and whether you're using an online spreadsheet or better yet, an online database tool like Airtable, that's going to be the first element to building any kind of no code solution. Now, for part two, we get into automation. Automation is where we're passing that information, either bringing it into our data source or getting it out of our data source. There are a number of different ways that you can build automation in no code, but they all follow the same rules. This is what I was talking about at the beginning of my video where I invited you to join me for that automation training. All automation starts with a trigger that leads the automation to start. It's what activates it. And then the actions that follow the trigger are the steps that you are automating. And so it's simple now with just if this, then that logic to say when something happens, I want to pass that information over to a different software or do something else with it, whether that's send an email, a message in Microsoft Teams or Slack, create a document, send something out for e-signature. These are all very automatable tasks. If you think about it, any action where you have simply copied and pasted data in the past, that is something, my friends, that you can almost undoubtedly automate by building some sort of automated workflow inside of no-code tools. In terms of automation options, many of the different database tools that you might look into using, remember that's the first part, well, they might have automation as part of their software. Airtable, for example, allows for some automation inside of the Airtable tool. But quite often, that automation alone is insufficient. So for this, we generally go into third-party tools as well. I'm thinking about Make, I'm thinking about Zapier. These are the leading tools that allow you to connect with other software on the internet and pass information from one place to another by building no-code automation. Now, the third step here is about the front end. How do people interact with this tool that you're building? Very often, you will need to build some sort of user interface for people to actively engage with the tool. Now, sometimes if you're building an internal tool, you can allow people to access that tool directly. So you would simply add users to your Airtable base, for example. But many times when you're building an app in no code, you want to make sure that people get limited access to that data. And so for this, we very often go to third-party front-end tools. For this, my front-end tool of choice is softr.io, but there are many others that you might consider as well. So by combining these three different elements, a database backend, workflow automation, and interactivity through a front-end user interface, we are able to now build our full suite app. The best part of this is we get all of this functionality for literally just under a couple hundred dollars a month, which for most small businesses is a really affordable expense for the amount of power and sustainability that an app like this will give any business. Now, the last part of this really comes into how do you start building in no code? Where do you start? What should you look for when you are engaging in any kind of no code project? Whether you are building this project yourself or if you're hiring a consulting group like ours to help you along the way. So, every single project is going to follow a basic framework in no code. I always encourage you to start with some sort of mind mapping process. For this, you want to understand how information flows in and out of your business process. You might be surprised how many business owners can't even articulate how they deliver their services. And if you can't articulate how you deliver your service, well, then there's no way that you can ever build an app to help you deliver it better. So, the first step is always planning, building a good outline, mapping out the flow of information as the information flows in and out of the company, where that information needs to be, and who needs access to it and when. Now, once you have this all mapped out, now it's time to start building. We always start by building the back-end database first. You have to build the information storage first and foremost. Once you have the proper data structure in place, you can layer on top of that automations and subsequently layer on your front-end interface as well. Once you have your project built, it will generally move into yet a third stage, which is the support phase. Nothing is ever really done with no code. As you're building an app, you might wake up 2 months later in the middle of the night and realize that there's something you could add or an improvement you could make to the overall functionality. And so for this is why I say that a project is never really done. It really just stays in that support phase in perpetuity. Once you've mapped it out, implemented the original design, then you're in support where you will consistently update and improve that app that you've built. What we're talking about here is incredibly revolutionary, and it is the next generation of software because what it allows us to do is build customized workflows, unique systems for our own business or businesses, and we can do it for peanuts compared to what we did before. The best part is we don't have to know how to code in order to deploy these solutions. As I mentioned, it's all just using logic. So if you can imagine it, there's a good chance you can build it. I hope you got a ton of value from this. Be sure to subscribe to this channel if you want to stay on top of no code and no code tools, and I will see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.